While a turbocharger is a great solution to making more engine power, we can end up with problems with turbo boost response, particularly with larger turbochargers. When the driver gets back on the throttle, there can be a period of lag before the turbo reaches full boost and the engine produces full power. Now, of course, this lag can be problematic, particularly in the likes of rally and rallycross, where instant response is essential. A common solution to this problem has been the addition of an anti-lag system. Now, anti-lag works by bypassing air around the throttle body and by retarding the ignition timing so that the combustion process is occurring in the exhaust system. Now, in a simple, common anti-lag system, the anti-lag is activated by either opening the throttle body or using an air bypass valve to bypass compressed air around the throttle body and into the plenum. Now, this does work quite well. However, it can be problematic if we want a very aggressive anti-lag strategy. In order to make the anti-lag more aggressive and provide more boost when the driver gets back on the throttle, we need to bypass more air around the throttle body. And with this conventional system, because the air and fuel is still partially combusting inside of the engine, of course it produces engine power and engine torque. The result of this is when the driver gets off the throttle approaching a corner and gets on the brakes, the car still tends to push or drive forward, and this can be quite difficult for the driver to control. In World Rallycross, the solution that's being used here is to apply a fresh air valve that supplies air directly into the exhaust manifold. This means that the air doesn't need to pass through the combustion chamber, and this gives a lot more control to the anti-lag strategy. Now, with this system, the throttle body doesn't need to be opened at all, and instead the air is supplied straight from the compressor side of the turbocharger, straight through the anti-lag valve and into the individual exhaust runners. So this provides the fresh air required for combustion. And here within the ECU strategy, the additional fuel is then injected as well. Now, particularly with a direct injected engine, even more control is applied here because the injection strategy can be employed where the fuel is delivered during the exhaust stroke. This means that the combustion is happening essentially completely in the exhaust manifold, providing a lot of exhaust gas energy to drive the turbocharger, and we don't have that problem with the car tending to push. The car still provides normal engine braking, which is exactly what the driver would expect. The end result of all of this is an incredibly effective anti-lag strategy where the driver still has complete control of the engine and it responds as expected, but when the driver gets back on the throttle, they can have instant boost. And in this case, it's possible to maintain turbo speeds of around about 100,000 RPM even at idle or any time the driver's off the throttle.
If you like that video, make sure you give it a thumbs up, and if you're not already a subscriber, make sure you're subscribed. We release a new video every week. And if you like free stuff, we've got a great deal for you. Click the link in the description to claim your free spot to our next live lesson.